Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Dental Lovers. Today we will be discussing the second division of your trigeminal nerve, which is your maxillary nerve, in detail. Just to recall you, the trigeminal nerve has three divisions. That is your maxillary nerve, which is your second division. The first division is your thalamic nerve, and the third division is your mandibular nerve, which we have already discussed. Today we will do the maxillary nerve in detail. First, this maxillary nerve originates from your trigeminal ganglion. So, before leaving, it gives some meningeal branches to supply the dura mater of this middle cranial fossa. Now, this foramen, that is a foramen rotundum, through which the maxillary nerves exits this middle cranial fossa and enters into the pterygopalatine fossa. This fossa contains the largest parasympathetic ganglion, that is your pterygopalatine ganglion. Here, it gives the branches, that is your ganglionic branches, which you can see here, these two are the ganglionic branches. Or we call it as branches to pterygopalatine ganglion. Right? Then the second branch here is your zygomatic nerve. So the zygomatic nerve further divides into the two nerves, zygomaticotemporal nerve, which comes out of its respective foramen and supply the temporal region, and zygomaticofacial nerve, which comes out of its respective foramen to supply the skin of that area. Now here, this branch which connects the zygomaticotemporal nerve to the lacrimal nerve here. This is very important. This is your communicating branch. Now, what is its role? In the initial video, we have discussed about the facial nerve. There was a ganglion, that was a geniculate ganglion, which is formed. Through that, the first branch that comes out was your greater petrosal nerve. That combines to this pterygopalatine ganglion. Now, what happens is, from the superior salivatory nucleus, the parasympathetic fibers originate. We have this greater petrosal nerve. It comes to this pterygopalatine ganglion. Then through this ganglionic branches, they enter the maxillary nerve. And then through the zygomatic nerve, it enters into the zygomaticotemporal nerve. Then through this communicating branch, it enters the lacrimal nerve to supply this gland in the eye, which is your lacrimal gland. So this produces your tears. This is the mechanism which is related to this nerve. Now the third division here is your posterior superior alveolar nerve, which supplies the molars of your maxilla and the gingival tissue of this region. In the infraorbital canal, it gives two branches. One is your middle superior alveolar branch and another one is your anterior superior alveolar branch. Right? So middle superior alveolar branch supplies the premolars of maxilla. An anterior superior alveolar branch supplies the anterior teeth of maxilla. Now here, this is the foramen, which is your infraorbital foramen, through which this nerve comes out as infraorbital nerve. Now here comes a very important point, that the infraorbital nerve is the continuation of your maxillary nerve and gives your terminal facial branches, nasal branches and branches to supply the upper lip. Now coming to the branches of your maxillary nerve. In the middle cranial fossa, it gives your meningeal branches. In pterygopalatine fossa, it gives your ganglionic branches, zygomatic branches, which was further divided into zygomaticofacial and zygomaticotemporal and posterior superior alveolar nerve. In the infraorbital canal, it gives your middle superior alveolar nerve and anterior superior alveolar nerve. The infraorbital nerve is the continuation of your maxillary nerve.
Thank you friends for watching my video. Do like, share, comment and subscribe to my channel. And please press the notification bell on. Thank you.